Welcome back. Today I have another great idea for holiday gift giving from the kitchen. This is a delicious cereal snack mix that is not savory. It's sweet and delicious. It's full of dried cranberries and almonds and orange flavor, and you are gonna love it. Let's go see how this all comes together. Okay, we're gonna get started making this really delicious and a little unusual snack mix. You know, we're all used to that really traditional snack mix that we make with the cereal squares, and that is a family favorite around here. But several years ago, I came across this. I've tweaked it to suit my own tastes, and it is one of my personal favorites. And I thought it would just be something a little bit different that you could share this holiday season. You can never really have too many ideas of new things that you can make and give away. But I promise you, when you taste this, you're probably gonna wanna keep some for yourself. So this is made very similarly to the traditional mix. We're gonna bake this in the oven, and I'm gonna use my brand new Wonder Cooker pan. If you guys haven't seen those advertised, they're fantastic. I'm gonna show you mine in just a minute. But this all starts off with 6 cups each of rice cereal squares and corn cereal squares. In order to flavor this up, we're gonna use 1/4 cup of frozen orange juice concentrate. Mine's thawed out. I just scooped it right out of the little container. 1/2 cup of butter, or 1 stick that's melted, 1/4 cup of granulated sugar, and 1 teaspoon of salt. And the add-ins is where the magic happens. We're gonna use 1/4 cup of very finely chopped candied ginger. You can leave this out if you don't like ginger. I'm using 1 1/2 cups of slivered almonds, 2 cups of dried cranberries, and 1 cup of golden raisins. These things you can switch out if you like, but I do encourage you to try this the way it's written the first time, because I promise you it's delicious. I get it if you don't like the candied ginger. Rick doesn't like it either. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go ahead and mix all the dry things together. And then we're just gonna go ahead and stir it up, just incorporating everything very well. And don't worry too much, because honestly, you're gonna stir this a lot over the next hour or so, because this has to bake in a very low oven for a very long time in order to set this really delicious orangey glaze that we're gonna create onto the cereal and all the dried fruit. And if you've got a lot of clumpy fruit here, then you're gonna wanna break it up a little bit. Okay, I'm just gonna get that out of the way for a second. Oh, I forgot to put the candy ginger in there, but. Okay, so I've got the orange juice concentrate, and you don't wanna dilute that at all. So this isn't just plain orange juice. It's orange juice concentrate, the kind that you get in the freezer in the little canister. Yeah, there goes our sugar, our salt, and our melted butter. And I'm just gonna whisk this together, and that's your glaze. Now, if you want to, you can add cinnamon or apple pie spice in here. That would be a really lovely addition if you want to, but I am a bit of a purist and I really just like this delicious orangey gingery flavor. You're gonna get a lot of flavor from that candied ginger, and that's why you don't really need to add a whole lot of extra spice. Okay, now I sprinkled the candied ginger over the top here, and now I'm just gonna add in all of this deliciousness. Get that on in there and stir. And get this really well coated with that glaze. So I'm gonna go continue stirring this up until it's all well coated, and then we'll come back and I'll show you what happens next. I said earlier we're gonna be using my new Wonder Cooker, and that's what we're gonna use to cook off this snack mix in, because I love using a deep roasting pan when I cook off snack mix, because it's easier to stir it every 15 minutes when you can dig deep and just kind of fold it over itself. It makes it a lot easier than trying to turn it on a baking sheet. This is something I've been doing for years, and it works out really, really well. The folks at Copper Chefs sent me this Wonder Cooker, and first of all, I just want to say thank you. This video is not sponsored. I'm just sharing with you this amazing tool. I love this pan. It's a great roasting pan. It's a Dutch oven. You can use it as a fryer, you can use it as a crisper, it's fantastic. And it even has this funky little lid that you can use to infuse like wine or flavored butter. into whatever you're roasting, and it will kind of self-baste. There's a tiny little hole in there, and it will kind of self-baste. It's really cool. I have never used it like that yet, but I'm not going to spend too much time on this today. If you guys are interested in a more in-depth video about the Wonder Cooker, let me know, and I'll put it on the schedule for after the new year, because right now we're focusing on the holidays and getting ready to share with family and friends. It comes with these two fryer baskets. It comes with this Copper Chef crisper tray, and you can use this outside of the Wonder Cooker. You can use it to make French fries on a baking sheet, and it makes it a lot easier to get crispy results. And then it also comes not only with that infusion lid, but it comes with this. It's got this kind of grill pan deal. You can use it as a lid like this, or you can use this as a Dutch oven roaster. You can flip it upside down and you can use the big part as a lid. But today, we're not using any lid. Today we're just gonna use the pan part. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and put our cereal mix, our snack mix, right in here. And I have my oven preheated to between 250 and 300 degrees. You don't want this to be too hot because you don't want it to burn. So I'm gonna pop it in my oven for 1 hour, and I'm gonna stir it every 15 minutes. So make sure you set your timer for 15 minutes every time you put it, when you put it in, set it for 15 minutes, and then take it out, stir it really, really well, give it a really good toss, and pull all the stuff up from the bottom and get in there, and then put it back in the oven, set it for another 15 minutes, and so on and so forth until it's been in there for approximately an hour. Now, because every oven is different, and some run low and some run high, you wanna make sure you watch this closely. We've got some sugar in here and some orange juice that can tend to burn, so you wanna make sure you watch it really, really closely. At the 45 minute mark, you can decide whether or not it's done enough for you. If it's glazy and brown and caramelized looking and delicious, then you wanna take it out and not give it that last 15 minutes. So, all right, there is our festive cranberry orange snack mix. Your imagination is your only limit when it comes to these cereal snack mixes. You can make so many different flavor combinations. This happens to be one of my favorites. This was in the oven for an hour and 15 minutes. I thought it would be enough at around 45, but it wasn't. The way that you'll be able to tell is that when you stir it, it's gonna feel like it's drying out. And you don't want your fruit to burn, so a good indicator that it's time to take it out of the oven is when you see your raisins getting really plumped up because they're getting ready to start burning. That's when you want to take it out, because once they cool down, they're going to go back to their normal raisiny self. This was in my oven at 275 degrees for an hour and 15 minutes. I stirred it every 15 minutes, and then when it came out, I took two baking sheets and I lined them with parchment, and I spread this out on equally. I put half on one sheet and half on the other, and I spread it out. This just helps it to cool down more quickly, and it also helps it to dry out more evenly. Then you can put it in an airtight container, like something like this. This is what I'm gonna store mine in. And that's what's left that didn't fit in the plate there. You can just enjoy it. You can make several batches. You can give it away as gifts. Cellophane bags are fantastic. You can put this in mason jars if you want to. Like a 2-quart mason jar full of this would be a fantastic gift for a neighbor or a church friend or a family member who is hard to buy for, but they love snacky foods. Everybody loves a food gift. You know why? Because they don't have to sell it at a yard sale 2 years from now. It doesn't take up space, it doesn't collect dust, it needs no maintenance except to consume it. So this is why food gifts are so welcome this time of year. This is one of them. This is one that I love. Even Rick likes this one, and it's not too gingery. It just has the perfect balance of sweetness and crunchiness. It's delicious, and I hope that you give it a try. You'll be able to find this recipe on my website. There will be a link down below. You can click through and get it. I think you're gonna love it. I'll also leave a link down below to where you can get more information about the Wonder Cooker. And you know what? That would be a really great Christmas gift for the foodie in your life or on your Christmas list. They will really appreciate that. There are so many uses for that. They say it replaces or stands in for 14 different things in your kitchen.
What you can put on your list?
or put it on, or you can put it on your own list, right? You might enjoy it too. I think it's just wonderful, and it will work on the induction burner as well. I'm going to be doing several recipes coming up in the new year using the Wonder Cooker, so stay tuned and I'll be sure and share them. And also be sure and let me know if you want to see a more in-depth video about what the Wonder Cooker is capable of doing, and we'll be sure and put that on the list after the first of the year. So that will do it for our cranberry orange cereal snack mix. So I hope you liked today's video, and if you did, please consider giving me a thumbs up. And if you're new to my kitchen and you wandered on over looking for some great holiday food gifts that you can make yourself, welcome. It's always a pleasure to have new friends join me. Be sure and hit that subscribe button. And as always, if you're a tried and true member of the Noreen's Kitchen family, be sure and hit the bell notification button and set your homepage to your subscription feed here on YouTube so you don't miss out on all the real food for real people, real easy recipes that we present all the time right here on our YouTube channel and straight from our kitchen. I hope you give this cranberry orange snack mix a try sometime soon, and I hope you love it. And until next time, happy holidays!